about time to begin. First song will be number 5. After this song, Brother Chris will be opening prayer. We'll do the first, second, and fourth verse.
When upon my still hopes you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one, count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Are you ever burdened with the load of care? Does the cross seem heavy you are called to bear? Count your many blessings, every doubt will fly, and you will be singing as the days go by. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has. name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us to be here again, together in the week. We thank you for allowing your son Jesus to go to the cross and die for our sins. Thank you for this time that you be with us, we come to you in prayer. That we come to you with a repentant heart, mindset, that our prayers will be heard at this time. Thank you that you continue to watch over us here at the church. Continue to give us the strength to extend our spirit and truth according to our word and purpose. Be with us throughout the worship service here this morning, that we will have our mind focused on your word, and that we will block up those things that this world. Lord, I ask you that you be with those of us who couldn't make it here today, for whatever reason may be, that you will work out those things in our lives. Continue to be with us as we move forward through the year, that you will continue to give us the strength to rely on that word to face each day and challenges that may come about. I ask you that you be with me this morning as well as I bring forth that lesson, that you will help me to remember the things that I've studied, and that you will continue to keep us safe. Pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Song for the Lord's Supper will be 383. If you're able, please stand to the prayer.
Help us, Lord, thy love.
loops. We pray that we will block out the things that are going on inside, outside these walls, and focus on what is going on inside. That our minds reflect back to that day. We ask all this in the Lord and Savior Jesus' holy name. Read from Philippians chapter 2, start from verse 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Jesus Christ, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant, and coming in the likeness of man, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Will you pray with me, please? Our Father in heaven, as we partake of this loaf that represents the body of our Jesus Christ, we pray that we will remember, Lord, he didn't have to do this, but he did it for the love that he had for us and for you. We pray, Lord, that we will remember this pain and the suffering that he went through for us. We take this loaf and pray that we will do so in a manner pleasing to you. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
next song will be 350. 350. At this time, 619. We'll do the first, second, and fourth verse.
Love the Lord and let our joys be known. Join in a song of sweet accord. Join in a song of sweet accord. And thus around the throne, and thus around the throne, we're marching to Zion. Beautiful, beautiful Zion. We're marching upward to Zion, the beautiful city of God. Let those who used to sing, who never knew our God, but children of the heavenly King, but children of the heavenly King, may speak their joys abroad, may speak their joys abroad. We're marching to Zion, beautiful, beautiful Zion. We're marching upward to Zion, the beautiful city of God.
Scripture reading this morning will come from 2 Peter. 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And Brother Chris will bring the lesson.
Went through a couple of scriptures and picked out some key scriptures that will help us along this journey as we face trying times, as we face even the world around us daily. The scripture this morning as he read from 2 Peter, chapter 1, 3 through 4. If we look at that, we know that the Bible gives us those things that pertains to God. So, as I go through this, just keep in mind that neither of us here is perfect, but we know that the Word of God is. So, as we read, let's go to Colossians 3:17. And these are those scriptures that I believe that helps our stewardship here on earth as Christians. Colossians 3:17. And it says, whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. So, deeds, words, actions that pertains what coming from us as Christians. Sometimes I think we go on through life and we never really sometimes go back to the scriptures to really see where are we or standing with God. Either we're faithful members or faithful stewards, right? We want to please God. So we want to keep in mind those deeds. And when he says, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, to the Father by him, how are we dealing with the world around us on a daily basis? We know that trials and temptations are going to come. But the most important thing when those trials and temptations come, that we apply ourselves according to the Bible and the scriptures concerning those issues. And we also can read, you know, how Jesus dealt with situations as well. And we also can get it out of 3:17. And also, I have a scripture from 1 Timothy 5:22. And my outline was, how must we make conscious decisions concerning other people's actions towards each other? And we can get a good example from 1 Timothy 5:22. It says, lay hands suddenly on no man, neither be partakers of other men's sins. Keep thyself pure. Be careful what we allow from others. It's basically what they're saying. Let's be careful. Let's make sure we keep ourselves pure. Our conscience, any habits that we may have. So, there are many examples given. The only excuse that we may have on this journey is not studying the Word, not applying the Word, not meditating on the Word. That would be the only excuse. It was mentioned this morning during class. Sometimes, you know, it's best to go back to the scriptures before we go on to things personally. Feel like we out here in the world alone. Romans 12:17-21. man, be clean, provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible as much, why then you live peacefully with all men? Never do love, avenge not yourself, but neither give place on the wrath wherein vengeance is mine. I will reply, says the Lord. Therefore, if thy enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirst, give him drink. For in so doing, it is not to heap coals of fire on his head. Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good. Another good example of us showing that stewardship that God wants to have when trying times come in our life. This is important. The way the world's going. Challenge. It's a battle daily. Spiritual as well as just dealing with it physically. And these scriptures are there to encourage us. Also, I'm going to take it back to the time of David. First Samuel chapter 17. We all know the story of David. He was most famously known for, you know, killing the giant, right? Pebble stone, one shot type of deal. And I think David gives us a good example as well as this. Just do the best we can with what we have. We know the history of David, son of Jesse. Let's go to 1 Samuel 17. We'll look at chapter 13. I'll read a couple of scriptures and emphasize on that. But 14, David was the youngest, and the three elders followed Saul. But David went and returned from Saul to feed his father's sheep in Bethlehem. And the Philistines drew near morning and evening and presented himself 40 days. And Jesse said to David, his son, take now for thy brother in the ephod of the fresh corn and these 10 loaves and run to the camp to thy brother. And carry these 10 sheep to the capital of the thousand to look out thy brother and far take their pledge. Now Saul and they and all the men of Israel were in the valley of Elah fighting with the Philistines. And David rose up early in the morning and left the sheep with the keeper and took and went as Jesse had commanded him. And he come to the trench as to how the host was going forth to fight, shouting for the battle. But Israel and the Philistines had put the battle in array, army against army. And David left his carriage in the hand of the keeper of the carriage and ran to the army and came and saluted his brother. And as he talked with them, behold, they're coming. The champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, out of the armies, out of the Philistines, and spake according to the same words that they heard them. And all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him and was sore afraid. And the men of Israel said, have you seen this man that is come up surely to defy Israel? He cometh up and shall be that man who killeth him. The king will enrich him with great riches, and will give him his daughter, and make his father's house free in Israel. And David spoke to the men that stood by him, saying, what should be done to the man that killed the Philistine and take away the reproach from Israel? And who is the uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God? And the people answered him, saying, this man is saying, so shall it be done to the man that killeth him. And Eli, his eldest brother, heard when he spoke to the men. Eli, with anger, was kindled against David. And he said, why comest thou nigh hither? And with whom hast thou left those true sheep in the wilderness? I know thy pride and the mightiness of thy heart, for thou art come down that thou mightest see the battle. David said, what have I now done? Is there not a cause? And he returned from him toward another and spoke afterward the same matter. And the people asked him again afterward the former matter. And when David heard of his daddy stuff that rehearsed them for Saul, and he sent for him. And David said to Saul, let no man or fail because of him, that servant will go and fight with the Philistines. We see the bravery of David. And sometimes, you know, we have to go to the word to get that strength, but we're going through battle. That we have the same bravery as David, even dealing with worldly situations. Could be our struggling sin that we can carry in our life. Could be something that calls us to, I say, withdraw. You know, some people have a weakness to withdraw from people. Some deal with, I think, you know, they call it sociological issues, like the anxiety. It might be a fear of somebody saying, you're not worthy enough. You know, so as a Christian, we know that God is with us well as I go. And David is showing a good example with his bravery. You know, being young with those brothers going up against the battle to fight a giant. But, you know, he knows through the stands here in 1 Samuel, it reads that, you know, David had to be reminded of the time that, you know, God was with him during the time of him and the lion. You know, he quoted that to them. He let them know, God was with me then, he's going to be with me now. And I think that's very important that we know through this journey, we whatever we face. You know, I found myself the last, you know, couple of days, you know, when I was gone last week, being concerned about the church here, which I should be. We all should be. You know, and what we should get out of that is we don't just ball all these things up. This example that Brother Patrick had this morning, we rely on each other. We rely on the word. The Bible teaches us to admonish one another, to encourage one another. So we must keep those things in place throughout this journey. Because if you don't, you're going to find yourself in those dark places that sometimes will make it harder for you to receive those things that your brothers and sisters are trying to give you for encouragement. And sometimes it blocks us from the thing that God wants us to do here on this journey too, according to his word. You know, it's not a magic myth. But one thing we do know, we have facts. We have the word, which is facts. We have examples. So when are these examples needed from the Bible? Daily. These examples are needed daily, whether we go and read the scriptures or they're already playing in our hearts and our minds. So I didn't have a long passage this morning, but I had some key verses just to get straight to the point. You know, and that's what I like about the Word of God. It can be straight to the point. It doesn't have to go all the way around here and come back here to be what it is. You know, I've been like that. I honestly believe since I first became a member of the church. You know, we all approach this thing differently. Some pastors for certain members, I think, stronger to the word than others. Some may need more examples. Some may need more evidence of the Bible. But what more do you need than those verses that sometimes sticks out more than others? This is not a journey that we're just on. Remember, the scripture I gave this one earlier out of Colossians. Whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father by him. There's no other way around it. You know, if we're giving thanks in our deeds to God, we're careful, we're cautious on how we relate to things on this earth. Our attitudes, I think, you know, that's the first most important thing we must have in place here on this journey, our attitude. That determines our I think, the whole realm of things, our stewardship, that attitude. You know, so we must keep in mind that it must stay and be within the way that God says it to be. And as I said, we must, you know, guard our hearts daily if we walk on this earth. Redeeming the time because the days are evil. Ephesians 5:16. Redeeming the time because the days are evil. How are we redeeming our time? We're studying it. We're making conscious decisions on the things that we allow in our life. that word of recompense that we used earlier in scripture. Recompense is, I looked up the definition yesterday. There's numerous definitions, but you know, it's giving awards to something according to how it comes back. Affection recompense. So we want to make sure that we recompense anything according to God's purpose. Remember, he says, recompense no man evil for evil. Provide things only in the sight of all men, if it be possible, as much as I have in you. Live peacefully with all men. You know, again, I put myself with the other example. You know how you ever wanted something so bad, and no matter how you got it, you just knew that you was going to try to get that which you wanted? It makes you emotional. You know, sometimes it will make you emotional. It will make you sometimes question, you know, people say your own sanity. And when it comes to the church, I make sure that those emotions I have concerning the church here is aligned with God's word. It only helps build a character if you apply the word to those situations. And throughout this journey, we must be careful of our stewardship. Don't allow so much of the world to overpower us here at the church as people. Because when you start doing that, when you start getting too much of your plate, that's when you start losing focus on what the Bible has in store for us here on this journey. I'm always bringing that stewardship part. You know, I didn't know this in there, but you know, we go back to the part of the, I always go back to the rich man with who wanted to do all the barns. You know, and God, you know, said, you know, who shall man go to if that's the last of you life? And the king and the servants of the talents, how, you know, one went out and he brought back certain folks, you know, the other one did nothing with his talent. So what are we doing here at the church? I'm here to encourage this morning. What are we doing with the talent that God has given us? Let's be sure that we're not just living this journey to be going through the motions, because that's not going to get us to where God has planned for us to head. We must apply the word to our lives, and we must apply it also in our deeds, our actions, as I stated in the scriptures earlier. And the David topic, you know, it hit me this morning too. I like David's teachings. Like he's writing some Psalms. I think he gets, you know, way intimate with God from his experience. We should get intimate with God on a spiritual journey. I think that helps us to refocus. It helps us to come out better than we was before as well as journey as Christians. So, as I get ready to end this lesson, I ask that you just take the scripture for what it is. And to the audience, We always offer invitation. It's not a man-made invitation, but a God invitation. To hear the good news of salvation in Christ. And first, you must hear the gospel. You must hear it. So then you must believe the gospel. You must repent of your sins. This is a change of mind. You must confess Jesus, who is the Son of God. And then you must be baptized into Christ. We yield the truth to God by faith in Christ Jesus. Of course, many of you have been baptized into Christ and put on Christ. Galatians 3, 26 and 27. And also, last but not least, you must live faithful unto death. time is we can extend the same. If you make any prayers for the church, it doesn't have to actually be something major, but to make any prayer for strength. Maybe you haven't been living a conscious life the way God wants you to on this journey. You might need prayers for the church that you get strong in those areas that you're not living consciously for God in. And also, doing this invitation, if you haven't put on Christ in baptism, we ask that you do so at this time to the listening audience. If there's any error that I may have spoken on, reach out to the church here through the website that we have, reach us on Facebook. And if you decide to respond to the invitation, ask that you get to your nearest church there, Church of Christ, or to the Word. And as I reemphasize, as I was John 6, 43-45, there's an offer here. John 8, 24, a believer of the gospel. Luke 13, 3, of repenting of sins, change of mind. Also Acts 17, 30 as well. Confessing Jesus, the example. Acts 8, 35-38. And also again, baptisms of Christ will be found in Galatians 3, 26-27. Ask at this time, if you stand the same, come forward and have to respond to the invitation.
There's a great day coming, a great day coming, there's a great day coming by and by, when the saints and the sinners shall be parted right and left. Are you ready for that day to come? Are you ready? I'll exchange my
once again humbly approach your throne of grace this morning. Lord, we thank you for this time that we've been able to gather here to worship you. We pray that our worship was in spirit and in truth as you have commanded us as your servants, as your children. Lord, we pray that as we leave this place, we will take your word with us, that we will always meditate upon it, that we will allow it to be engrafted in our hearts. We pray, Lord, that we will always have an attitude of prayer, and that if we do fall short, that we will remember that we have the blood of your Son Jesus to wash us and cleanse us to keep us pure in your sight. Lord, we pray that we will always remember to have the authority of your Son Jesus in all that we do, and that we will always remember to teach your word to others so they too can have the opportunity of being within the church, that avenue of getting to heaven, because we know that it is not just for us, but it is for others as well. We pray, Lord, that we will always be free to worship you in this country. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for you giving of your only Son that gives us this avenue of worship and this hope of heaven. And it's in his name that we pray. Amen.
Drop the floor.